Yeah, real stealthy. You stop screaming about them. I'll be on their last legs.
Who sent you?
Hey, easy.
Anders.
Who are you working for?
Helen.
You're a Nobu Arasaka. Do you wish to take me back?
Pathetic rat's got nowhere left to scurry off to. He's out of lifelines. Shut him up already.
Don't much like him, do you, Johnny?
Not a fan, I take it.
You haven't found a fan in him either. Motherfucker doesn't know who to be scared of more, you or Arasaka.
Me. Well, nothing personal, guy.
Don't take this personally.
Seem to recall you were gonna tell Takamura when you got Hellman.
Yeah, just a sec. I'll call him.
Call Takamura. Okay. Nothing else cool in here. Oh, she's still screaming about that.
Just remember, you have Hellman, and that's one hell of a card. Try to win something with it.
Takamura saved my life, remember?
Because it was in his fucking interest to do so. Still just Biz. He's no friend of yours.
You're loud now. Come on, Takamura, answer.
Takamura, good news. Got Hellman.
Alive. What did he say?
Alive. Alive. Not too talkative now. Taking him to the Sunset Motel.
I will come to you. Keep him there until I arrive.
You got it. See ya.
Okay. That means we have to deal with the reinforcements that will come.
Better take him somewhere you can talk in peace.
It's awkward.
True.
Outside is... Doesn't sound very peaceful out here. Talking in peace. I don't think I want to go out those big doors. Where do we come in? I mean, some people just pulled out. Oh, I can't open this now? I can't say it right now. Okay.
Looks like your new Chimbas are here.
Is that him?
Oh, sure is.
Good reinforcements.
Take him outside. Toss him on the bike.
We have good reinforcements.
Stay right there.
The cavalry has arrived. Mitch gathered together a few elder colonists.
The road was clear. I don't think we were spotted. We would still do better not to hang around too long.
What do you plan to do with him?
Regular convention here. It's a long story.
Huge long story. Not sure I'd even know where to start.
Tell me next time, then.
Saul.
Everything's done here. All clear.
I heard Mitch is alive thanks to you.
Thanks to V and Pan Am. They both saved my ass.
Yep.
I just hope he was worth it.
Saul, I tried to raise Scorpion. Maybe I could help out somehow.
I think you've helped enough.
I tried to stop him. Sure. Just turn around now. Let it all be damned. You're good at that, aren't you?
Good guy, don't be a jerk. It wasn't Pan Am's fault.
Look, Saul, it really wasn't Pan Am's fault.
Careful. You and me are not buddy-buddy. Besides, nobody's blamed anyone for anything yet.
Sure. Right.
I don't want to be your buddy.
Me. It was my doing, my fault that AV got hit. Without me, Scorpion and his people wouldn't have gone out to grab it. That's the truth.
When you're an Aldecaldo, you are always responsible for yourself and your people. The circumstances change nothing. Perhaps Pan Am should ask herself if she's still an Aldecaldo.
Perhaps you'd like to ask yourself, why am I not kicking your butt right now? Don't worry about Saul.
Hey, don't worry about Saul. I'll get over it.
I don't give a damn.
But he gives a damn about you, Pan Am. As soon as he heard what had happened, he ordered us to follow you. He was worried something would happen.
Saul?
Well,
that was his?
Look,
got a funny way of showing
it. Don't see eye to eye at the moment, but your family and Saul will do anything for family.
The thing is, am I even part of the family anymore?
You know you are. Come back to us. I understand.
Quite a convention.
Sorry you had to witness that.
What do I mean?
Things just get complicated.
What's going on with my
dramatic
hand?
Sometimes. But I will manage.
What's...
And you. You look out for yourself, all right?
Did I break my hand? What do you do now?
So, what now? Back to Night City?
Yeah. I mean, I think so. I have to sit and think about everything.
Maybe you should talk to Saul.
Saul, Mitch. They really treat you like family. Maybe you should give them a chance.
It is not that simple.
Like any family.
They're coming. You have about a minute to get out of there.
Let's move! Let's
get out.
I'm also headed out. Take care of Scorpion's bike. It's yours.
Oh, thanks. Oh, I thought it was on it already. So how do we... ride that with him draped over it? What do I sit on his back? Oh god, the crying person's still there. Hey! Wake up, buddy boy.
Hey!
Where am I? What is this place?
A motel in the middle of nowhere.
Motel? Middle of nowhere.
Any specific middle?
Nice.
Doesn't matter. You're not leaving here by yourself anyway.
Why are we here?
I want to talk about the biochip.
I want to talk about your little invention. Biochip you made for Arasaka.
Fine. But let's get one thing straight first. Yorinobu Arasaka didn't send you?
No.
This means you must have an offer for me. If your boss will pay more than Kang Tao, I believe we can talk.
Is it taking a shower or something? I got a problem. You're gonna help me kick it.
So
nobody
what
sent
do you propose?
I got a problem, and you're gonna help me.
And what does that have to do with the biochip?
It's in me, man. Your tech's trying to kill me.
Your tech's trying to kill me. Pretty sure that's not how it's advertised.
If you wish to file a complaint, I'll need more details.
Got Johnny Silverhand's construct stuck in my head. And I don't want it there.
Silverhand? Construct? That's impossible.
Mm.
Where did you get this biochip?
Very possible. That's a long story.
Long story.
If Arasaka finds me, I'm dead. So are you. So we are in no hurry. And I'm interested. Truly.
I stole it from Yorinobu.
Clept it off Yorinobu Arasaka. Job for a client, but the client left me out to dry.
And you decided the best place for it was in your own goddamn head.
Actually, wasn't a bad idea. Construct rebooted me when my own goddamn head took a bullet.
I always knew Yorinobu's plan would fail. I just never imagined it would turn out like this. Arasaka's prized tech really is in the very streets of the city.
In a matter of speaking, well, you gotta remove this thing from my system.
You have to remove the biochip from my system.
It's not that simple.
Look, you made the thing, didn't you? So where's the problem?
If you're telling the truth, you slotted in a new experimental version of the biochip.
I know you can't just pull it out.
I know you can't just yank it out. My ripper
you
said...
You showed that to some fucking street doctor? Who else knows?
I needed help. Or did you think the first thing that came to mind was downing a Kang Tao AV?
Okay. So experimental. How's that different from the normal one?
How's the prototype version different? It's got a different... engram? Something more...
aware?
Aggressive?
The biochip is what's unique, not Silverhand's engram. The previous version of the chip was only used to communicate with pre-saved engrams.
It was rare as fuck and cost a fortune. Yeah.
This one's rarer. Meant to install and activate the engram in a new body. When I left Arasaka, the project was still in the trial phase.
Huh. How exactly was it supposed to work?
How exactly was this new version supposed to work? Were you planning to have the engram kick people out of their own bodies? Is that shit by design?
During the tests, we assumed that the body would be neurally indifferent during implantation.
You mean dead?
Yes, which makes what happened to you interesting indeed.
You say so. It's not this kind of interesting that I'm into right now. Who could afford this version of the biochip?
How do you put a price on immortality? Who could even afford tech like this?
Nobody. This model was meant to remain in-house. The prototype was Saburo Arisaka's personal commission. He oversaw the entire project himself.
So if it weren't for you, Arinobu, nobody would have found out.
And if not for you, the project would not have been a success. This is a true breakthrough.
Well, mazel tov. Guess I'm lucky.
Huh. Imagine my luck. To be so fucking unique, so fucking exceptional. That mean you'll help me?
Well, well.
I would have to see it first.
I don't trust you.
Whoa, we just met. Haven't built up that sort of trust yet.
How did you think this was going to go? If you want me to help you, I must examine you.
Okay. But no funny moves.
Okay.
Unbelievable. It looks like...
Can't believe this suit's the one who's gonna help us.
Hopefully. I have my doubts.
Oh, fuck.
What is it?
What is it?
What a pity I won't be able to examine it fully.
Yeah, real shame. You could have been his guinea pig, too.
Tell me how to get rid of it.
I'm afraid I have bad news. Your neural network has completely deteriorated. It can no longer function independently of the chip.
What?
The only thing I could
do... Woohoo, it's bargaining time.
...is to give you information on a good clinic in Sweden.
Sweden?
They'll help you through the terminal stages. Minimize the pain.
You said the project was in a trial phase.
Wait, you said the project was in the trial phase. You don't actually know how it'll end.
Oh, I do. I just saw the construct devouring your brain. It's programmed to take over its new environment. At all costs. And your little meat brain is helpless against it.
So no matter what, sooner or later the engram wins.
Yes. And from what I've heard about Silverhand, that seems to be exactly his style.
Huh. I see my reputation's grown into Arisaka legend.
He just told me, but I don't have any other choice. What's happening to me exactly?
What exactly is going on in my head?
You tell me. What's it like to have two personalities?
Confusing.
Because it's not like you're hearing voices. You are both yourself and Silverhand, simultaneously.
I see him. I talk to him.
I can see him and talk to him.
You're not... talking, but yes, I understand what you mean. Have you noticed the construct's influence on your decision-making?
Sheesh, give it a rest.
He can't make me do anything.
When it comes to my decisions, Johnny really is just a voice in my head. Maybe he has a different opinion, but he can't make me do anything.
Agreed 100%. You are one fucking stubborn
It's not
host.
As if one of you wins the debate.
Thank you.
The scale simply shifts, slowly but surely.
What do you mean?
What do you mean?
You will start doing things that were once unthinkable, at least to your old self. And you know exactly who he was. A fanatic. A terrorist. A suicide bomber.
Well, fuck me. Who's trying to mess with your head now?
That is why I believe it would be better for you to consider clinical isolation at this stage.
Well, at least Johnny never made a whore of himself.
At least Johnny never whored himself out like you.
Are you defending him? Or is that Johnny speaking? Oh, let me guess. He already tried to take over your body. You know, just for a little while.
No.
Would you, though? Could be fun.
Johnny!
Kidding. But watch out. Suit's getting ready to talk your head off.
Right. Enough of this.
You know what? That's enough. You just playing for time? Because I can't tell. Are you trying to convince me you're useless? I mean, in that case, I can just shoot you in the head and save us both some time.
Oh, finally.
I will try to help you, if you come with me to Kang Tao.
I'll try doesn't cut it, buddy.
I'll try, just isn't gonna cut it. Actually, it's almost like you're trying to buy your way in with the Chinese at my expense.
Do you even realize how much data is in your head? Even if I can't help you, the data must be saved.
Well, fuck me sideways. What a half-brained gonk. He just admitted you're right.
Forget about Kang Tao.
Forget Kang Tao. Got any other ideas?
If you think there's anyone else who can help you, I could give you the blueprints. Complete project documentation. Kang Tao offered quite the sum for it.
You got it with you?
He's got to. Gonk's fucking useless without him.
He... Takamura? What the hell is he doing here?
He's got a few questions of his own for you. You play
That's
nice.
Right.
He might even save your ass.
Were they supposed to meet us
I'm
at the gas station?
Done. The blueprints.
I thought he said leave him at the gas station. He was going to meet us there. Then I forgot all about it. Now here he is at the motel. Engram container.
Better than nothing. Long as we find someone fluent in technobabble.
A Ripper Dock. Saburo Arasaka. Data set. Yeah, stuff. Okay. What do you do with them?
What'll you do with them?
I haven't decided yet.
Are you serious?
You know me. I can be impulsive.
Okay, girl. He's all yours.
He's all yours. I'll give you two some space.
I hope we can come to an understanding.
That is certainly in your best interest. V, I will remember this.
This heat. Whoa. Throat.
See that? Fuck me. Just look at that.
Unacceptable. Inhumane. That is not me.
Whoa.
Sons of bitches.
No. Mega blockers. Paranoid. That's what you are, Johnny.
You really are paranoid.
You don't see it? Way corpses are stripping our world and lives naked, piece by piece? Can't turn a blind eye to that.
Why are we talking about this?
Whatever you gotta say, say it. Got something eating at your code, that's clear.
Been trying to learn how you're wired this whole time. To know who I'm dealing with. Thought you were just unlucky at first. But I kept watching, and finally realized what your problem is.
Oh yeah?
Always been a corpo cog. A replaceable part. Once Sokka booted you out, stripped you of perks. Best you could hope for was to be a scav exterminator.
Seem to know a lot about my past.
You sure seem to know a lot about my past.
Well, seen flashes of your past, just like you've seen flashes of mine.
Why can't you just leave me alone?
Don't think I care. What does interest me is why you're a clingy creep.
I think we can work together, V.
But your plans make no sense. Destroy Arasaka? I don't even know what that means.
All in good time.
An enemy. You need to have one at all times, don't you?
You know what? Seems to me you need to have a nemesis. At all times. Ideally, a crazy powerful one to feed your ego. And they've gotta be practically unbeatable to justify a suicide run.
Huh. You're funny.
Yeah, I've been working on that. Though not ideal, I'm a nemesis to you, too.
Actually, that's what I am. That kind of nemesis. I'll decide your fate. Fuck all you can do.
Okay. I'll tell you why I want to destroy Arasaka, but I'll only tell you once. Want to hear it?
Oh, lucky me. Just once? Yeah.
All right.
I saw a corpse strip farmers of water, and eventually of land. Saw them transform Night City into a machine fueled by people's crushed spirits, broken dreams, and emptied pockets. Corps have long controlled our lives, taken lots, and now they're after our souls.
Don't exaggerate.
Come on, don't exaggerate.
V, I've declared war not because capitalism's a thorn in my side or out of nostalgia for an America gone by. This war's a people's war against a system that spiraled out of our control. It's a war against the fucking forces of entropy. Understand? Do whatever it takes to stop them, defeat them, gut them. If I gotta kill, I'll kill. If I need your body, I'll fucking take it.
Can't say I appreciate fucking that. Hell.
You still don't see it, but you will one day.
Tapeworm. There's a shard. Oh, I can level up too. I think I want to put. I haven't put anything in tech for a while. And we need this for some of the cyberware. So I'm going to put a tech in that. But I gotta put something in here, I think. Yeah. Mnemonic. Johnny Mnemonic, right? Reduces the cost of quick hacks used against an enemy already affected by a quick hack by 2 RAM units. So I'm guessing that would include the short circuit. Quick hacks that spread. Yeah, I'm gonna put this. Quick hacks deal 20%. Oh, we have 20. It'll be quick hacks deal 30% more damage. Cool. Our short circuit and whatever else is going to be even more powerful now. Oh, and there's a shard. I got a bunch to read. It's a technical thing about the chip. Relic 2.0 prototype specifications. Top secret. Clearance level P0. Declassification date. Not applicable. Project code. Blah blah blah. Project supervisor Anders Hellman. Approved by Saburo Arasaka. Project name Relic 2.0. Base algorithm. Soul killer. Relic 1.0. Secure your soul. Wait. Secure your soul. Relic. I'm gonna. Thought it said that. Preliminary review. Project summary. Unlike Relic 1.0, the latest version of the biochip prototype is not only designed to store a digitized engram for basic communication, but also an enhanced personality construct capable of independent function and re-implantation into a new organic host body. Relic 2.0's improved personality construct preserves the vast majority of the primary subject's cognitive and virtualized motor functions. Preliminary testing shows emotional output at 75% conformity levels. Note, we are only concerned with the construct's matrix coherence, not with its perceived authenticity. While volition fluctuates at 80 to 90% conformity, the success of the improved engram is largely owed to the use of experimental polyglycal structures as well as new synthetic granule neuron replicators within pseudomatrices. C-section stuff. A precondition of activating the Relic 2.0 is the ceasing of the host's vital functions. Brain death, cardiac arrest. Yeah, that's what he was telling us. Only complete and irreversible shutdown of neural activity can allow the engram to root itself and take over the body, i.e. reboot. Clinical trials using subjects. Sorry, that was a little dry. Clinical trials using subjects on the verge of biological death have proven unsuccessful in activating the Relic 2.0's basic functionality. In cases where subjects underwent biological death, upon taking out the biochip, showed promising signs of initial activity prior to lapsing. Identifying the causes of a failure, despite fulfilling all technical requirements, is the first step to achieving a breakthrough, i.e. complete activation of the Relic 2.0's construct in a suitably prepared organic host body. Full target description, see section 31B-02. I'll read the other shards at some other point. Are you the one who's been crying all this time?
All that meat's just slowing you down.
I'm just tired of hearing it, really. You've been crying for, like, forever. I can't go talk to Takamura or see what he's up to, okay. Alright, so what else we got going on? Something else. Tapeworm was updated. Okay, this is done. Is it one of these? Or is it just... They said it was updated, not completed or whatever. But maybe it was completed. I don't see it. I don't see a tapeworm. Well, okay. I don't know what that was all about. What if they have any more ammo? And then again, I have lots of that. Oh, I do need some more of this. I temporarily forgot how to do that. I'm gonna put the gun away. I don't know why. Oh, now you're here.
Oh, watch it. You'll swallow a fly.
I beg your pardon. I landed on her head.
What's up in the big world?
What's up in the big world? I need stuff. And I need to give you stuff. Surprised I didn't get overweight again. Oh wait, keeping that. For the memories. Look at that. New sniper rifle. Thought I picked up something cool over there. Widowmaker Tech Precision Rifle. So that was as good as the Sidewinder. Sidewinder actually has better headshot damage multiplier as well. Much better chance of poisoning people with chemical damage than shock, but yeah, I'll get rid of it. Am I sure I want to sell it? Oh, Nash's rifle. Looks like he won't be needing it anymore. Fires 2 projectiles per shot. And deals chemical damage with an increased chance to apply poison. Charged shots deal more damage. SPT-32 grad. Whoa. Look at that sucker. Nice. That's awesome. So I have the sniper scope already installed and a pulverized mod. And I'll sell you the other sniper rifle. Thank you very much. Now, if we run over here, there's an undiscovered thing. And there's actually a couple things around that are only moderate. Oh, there's a fixer over here we can visit. Yeah, I guess we'll go check this stuff out before we head back. Mostly just more spread out. So, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.